Trust it.
Hey everybody, Dr. O. This video we're going to talk about the fluoroquinolone antibiotics, but I have a couple more I want to add here, because we're talking about antibiotics that impact the ability of microbes to make DNA and RNA. So there's a couple that aren't on here, but will fit. So let's start with flagyl. So metronidazole, I hate saying that one, but flagyl is an antibiotic, but also can be an antiprotozoal, which is pretty cool. It interferes with DNA replication. So you may actually see that one. And then before we get to the fluoroquinolones, we should talk about the quinolones. So quinolones were produced as a byproduct of making the anti-malarial drug. They found these quinolones. The only quinolone that I want you to know is called nalidixic acid. It is only useful against urinary tract infections, but it is important. But then we've been able to chemically modify these quinolones to make the fluoroquinolones, and these are wildly important. So you have ciprofloxacin, which you see here, levofloxacin. So these are going to be examples of fluoroquinolones. What they do, just like nalidixic acid, they impact DNA gyrase. So DNA gyrase is an enzyme that bacteria use. As DNA is being unwound and replicated, it keeps these coils from forming that can cause DNA to break, and that's not a huge deal, but it is different than ours. We use a different enzyme. So it is selectively toxic. There doesn't mean there aren't side effects, but it is selectively toxic for that enzyme in anyway. This is going to be used for all sorts of infections, respiratory infections, abdominal infections, skin infections, you name it. So it's very these drugs like Cipro are very commonly prescribed because they're effective against gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria, making them broad spectrum. They are selectively toxic, and so that's why you see these in use so much. All right, so I talked about Cipro, ciprofloxacin being the big one there. I talked about nalidixic acid. All right, and then that flagyl I mentioned as well. So this is the last group of nucleic acid synthesis inhibiting antibiotics. So I hope this helps. Have a wonderful day. Be blessed.